Live from Washington, D.C. The Basilica of the National Shrine of the Immaculate Conception and the Eternal Word Television Network present the Solemn Mass of Christmas Day. With His Eminence Wilton Cardinal Gregory, Archbishop of Washington, as celebrant and homilist.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters in the Lord, on this glorious Christmas morning, we gather as God's family to receive the gift of His Son. Let us begin by acknowledging our sins and asking for the Father's forgiveness. I confess, mighty God, to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who wonderfully created the dignity of human nature and still more wonderfully restored it, grant, we pray, that we may share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
a reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwelt in the land of gloom, a light has shone. You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing, as they rejoice before you as at the harvest, as people make merry when dividing spoils. For the yoke that burdened them, the pole on their shoulder, and the rod of their taskmaster you have smashed, as on the day of Midian. For every boot that tramped in battle, every cloak rolled in blood, will be burned as fuel for flames. For a child is born to us, a son is given us, upon his shoulder dominion rests. They name him Wonder Counselor, God Hero, Father Forever, Prince of Peace. His dominion is vast and forever peaceful, from David's throne and over his kingdom, which he confirms and sustains by judgment and justice, both now and forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Sing to the Lord, bless his name. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to Titus. Beloved, the grace of God has appeared, saving all, and training us to reject godless ways and worldly desires, and to live temperately, justly, and devoutly in this age, as we await the blessed hope, the appearance of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us to deliver us from all lawlessness and to cleanse for himself a people as his own, eager to do what is good. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that the whole world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment when Quirinius was governor of Syria. So all went to be enrolled, each to his own town. And Joseph too went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David that is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. While they were there, the time came for her to have her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Now there were shepherds in that region, living in the fields and keeping the night watch over their flock. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were struck with great fear. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I proclaim to you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For today in the city of David, a Savior has been born for you, who is Christ and Lord. And this will be a sign for you. you will find an infant wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. And suddenly, there was a multitude of the heavenly hosts with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." The Gospel of the Lord.
My dearest brothers and sisters in Christ, the Gospels present us with an undeniable symmetry to be found at two pivotal moments in Jesus' life. The beginning of that life opens very much as it will temporarily close. Jesus' life is shrouded in poverty. He was noticed only by the poorest of the poor at those two occurrences, because only those insignificant people seemed to have enough faith to believe. Furthermore, his life begins and concludes in a borrowed setting. The Christmas story parallels the story of Calvary. Today, we rejoice that a baby has been given to us as an infant who had no home in which to be born. That same child, having reached his manhood, will then have no place in which to be buried. And there is a lesson to be learned in this pattern of living. Christ will spend 33 years desiring only one place wherein to dwell, our human hearts. Christmas and Calvary are stories about an infant and eventually an adult who was not looking for a residence, but only for hearts. Christmas and Calvary really tell a variation on the same story. It is a continuation of the legacy of God's presence in the midst of his people throughout the Old Testament. God always preferred to live in the midst of his people, and only reluctantly did he even agree to have a temple built in his honor. God always prefers to be an itinerant deity, dwelling in the midst of those that he loves. At Christmas, however, we rejoice at the beginning of his human life. The world is filled with joy and hope and peace as we once again recall the wonderful love that God has for all of us, confirmed by the birth of his Son. Some of us are so filled with gladness and with a sense of the stillness of the season that we will probably even briefly pause to give thanks for all that we have received. Today, Christian churches throughout the world will be crowded with folks whose hearts are overflowing with gratitude and enchanting human sentiments. Various people who may not ordinarily go to church will attend religious services today. Families that may rarely have the time to share a common meal because of their busy schedules will dine together on this day. Many of them will offer a heartfelt prayer of thanks for the gift of being a family. The human heart this day feels comfortable in allowing itself to brim over with joy. Enemies, warring nations, hostile neighbors, political foes may even halt their aggression this day out of respect for the Prince of Peace, whose birth brings both promise and a pause from such violence and hatred. We pray that might even be the case today in Ukraine. Even locally, some hearts that ordinarily hold only hatred for some other persons may allow a mercy, a brief moment of grace. This child, who 2,000 years ago was born in a stable, and as a crucified man will need to borrow another man's tomb, never seems to have a place to call his own. From the beginning to the end, Jesus lacks a place wherein to dwell. And herein is the most profound lesson of Christmas. Christ desires to live within our hearts, yours and mine, within each one of us. Jesus, who this day is born for us and will eventually die for us, wants only to live within us, and therefore to allow all of us to live more fully because of him. Jesus cares nothing about having a warm home in which to be born. He wants to live in our families. Jesus does not care if he has no grave wherein to be lain. He wants only to free our hearts from the death of hatred, envy, bigotry, violence, injustice, racism, and all of those human faults and sins that keep us fastened to death rather than freed for life. Jesus wants to live in our hearts, and there he will transform them into the warm, loving seats of mercy for which they were originally designed. My dear friends, may this Christmas soften all of our hearts, not simply with sentimental thoughts or nostalgic recollections from the past, but with the sincere desire and the hope that Christ has been born to bring us that perfect peace for which we have all been destined. May your homes be bright and joyful this Christmas, and may your hearts be open to Jesus, who wants to dwell only therein. God always prefers to live in the midst of the people that he loves. May God dwell in your home and in your hearts throughout this coming year. He very much desires that as his dwelling place. Merry Christmas, my dearest brothers and sisters. The baby that is born today simply wants to find a dwelling space in you and in me. We are really the only dwelling for which he has ever longed. Amen. The church throughout the world today joins hearts and minds in offering our one prayer of faith. I believe in one God, Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified, Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. On this holy day, we are filled with new hope in the saving power of God. Mindful of our Savior's love for his church, let us now offer our petitions in confidence.
That the celebration of our Lord's birth will inspire each of us to give joyful witness to the gospel and to share our faith with others in the perennial mission of evangelization. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all world leaders, that they will seek to protect the lives of the unborn, immigrants and refugees, freedom of religion, the sanctity of marriage, and to work continually for peace throughout the world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That many will devote their lives in loving service to the poor, the marginalized, the sick and homebound, and the elderly. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our military personnel serving overseas, for law enforcement officers, and fire and rescue workers. May God bless those who serve and protect our nation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God will bless the church with an increase of vocations to the priesthood, diaconate, and consecrated religious life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have been enrolled in the National Shrine's Christmas Novena and Shrine Prayer Guild Novena, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all those who have died and gone before us in faith may now share in the glory of God's heavenly kingdom forever. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, your Son's birth brought light and peace to a world darkened by sin and death. Hear the prayers we offer on this holy day and fill our hearts with unending joy. Through Christ our Lord.
We invite you to use the envelopes provided in the pews or visit the National Shrine online as a means of sharing in our ministry at the Basilica of the National Shrine. Thank you for your continued support and generosity. Thank you.
Thank you.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Make acceptable, O Lord, our oblation on this solemn day, when you manifested the reconciliation that makes us wholly pleasing in your sight and inaugurated for us the fullness of divine worship. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, for in the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him God made visible, we might be caught up through him in love of things invisible. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and me, your unworthy servant, with our auxiliary bishops, with Donald William, our retired archbishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the apostolic, Catholic, and apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them, we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offered for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true.
Celebrating the most sacred day on which Blessed Mary, the Immaculate Virgin, brought forth the Savior for the world, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept the oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Bless, O Lord, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies. Graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints, admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not waiving our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be.
Let us pray. Grant, O merciful God, that just as the Savior of the world born this day is the author of divine generation for us, so he may be the giver even of immortality, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Before the final blessing, please allow me to express our collective gratitude to Cardinal Wilton Gregory, the Archbishop of Washington and Chairman of the National Shrine Board of Trustees, for being with us on this Christmas Day. Your Eminence, thank you for your presence and for your fine homily. I'm also grateful to Father Ismael Ayala, our Director of Liturgy, as well as to Dr. Pilo Tona, our choir director, and our choir for making today's Mass a beautiful celebration of our Lord's birth. I'm delighted to extend a warm welcome to those who join us through our live stream broadcast, the Eternal Word Television Network, and the Catholic channel of Sirius XM Radio. I was reminded that last Christmas, we were all still wearing masks. So not only am I delighted to have you all with us this day, a standing room only crowd, but I'm thrilled to see your faces. To each of you, those gathered in this great basilica and those who join us through television and radio, it is the prayer of each of us here at Mary's Shrine that through the intercession of Mary Immaculate, you'll be filled with every blessing this Christmas and throughout the coming new year.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing.
May the God of infinite goodness, who by the incarnation of his Son has driven darkness from the world, and by that glorious birth has illumined this most holy day, drive far from you the darkness of vice and illumine your hearts with the light of virtue.
Amen.
May God, who willed that the great joy of his Son's saving birth be announced to shepherds by the angel, fill your minds with the gladness he gives and make you heralds of his gospel.
Amen.
And may God, who by the incarnation brought together the earthly and heavenly realm, fill you with the gift of his peace and favor and make you sharers with the church in heaven.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Far as the curse is found.